No, stanotte amore non ho più pensato a te. Ho aperto gli occhi per guardare intorno a me. E intorno a me girava il mondo come sempre. Gira il mondo, gira nello spazio senza fine, con gli amori appena nati, con gli amori già finiti, con la gioia e col dolore della gente come me. Un mondo soltanto. Io ti guardo, nel tuo silenzio io mi perdo, e sono niente accanto a te. Sempre il giorno, ed il giorno verrà. Oh, mondo.
Could sing a new song.
Mysterious is a word I much like to be said. I tend to hide between cracks of precious stones. It makes me feel safe from this earth's coldness. I'm an old soul living in a strange world. I like to watch the moon every night. I guess I'd rather live there than here. Do you know that smell after it rains? It has a name, petrichor. And as for me, I'm Penelope.
Lonely nights of scheming, everything depends on.
I am Mary, like the Virgin Mary. God is my savior, and his shadow is my home. They once told me I'm sweet as toffee and as graceful as rain. I go to church at least every Sunday and sing along to the melodies of our Lord. I'm drawn to pretty things and always have room for happy thoughts. My sister is my other half. I couldn't bear the thought of living without her.
With you by my side.
My name's Cecilia. Although I'm told to be 19, I feel like 25. I like to have a twin sister. It's like having a shadow. I think danger is what keeps the blood in my veins pumping. I like boys. They're like loyal dogs, always willing to be by my side. This world is so lucky to have me in it.
On you.
I read books. I look at science in the eye. I am said to be a psychic of romantic novels. I long to meet the love of my life. I guess I'm just a hopeless romantic. May I just say that paper and ink are what grounds me to this materialistic and superficial world. I smoke. I feel that as the ethereal ashes come in and out of my lungs, this toxic world of loneliness can no longer hurt me. See, I think there's more to life than what meets the eye. My name is Ophelia, and I am 20 years old.
Maybe you are, but I reach the sky, oh my, with you by my side.
Thank you. Ron, short for Ronald. I'm 21 years old. I smell like cigarettes before dawn, but I'm the only one who likes it. I enjoy feeling bad about myself, but I also like making people happy. I am an enigma to my parents and I don't believe in anything. Wish I could. It is hard for me to stay focused in things I'm not interested in, and I also feel like I'm wasting my time most of the time. I believe I have never felt the effect of adrenaline, which makes me crave a punch in the face. I used to play unconsciously with the feelings of people, but now I do it for the thrill of it. I like to believe I'm interesting after midnight, and I try to solve problems I don't have.
A garden wall.
I'm living, at last. This world feels like unrequited love. I can't stand it anymore. I spent the last years telling myself that I was getting better. But now I realize I'm not. Depression consumed every bit of me, every corner of my soul. Why water? It flows. It fits everywhere. It goes on. It's clear and there is no room for lies. It was my first contact with the world, and I shall make it my last.
I know what you'll be thinking right now. Mary, how could she? Well, I guess I couldn't stand it anymore. So many high expectations, and what for? To end up living a lie, because that's how I've been feeling my whole life. I've been having dark thoughts for a while, but my innocence won't let me feel them. There's still a tiny voice in my head trying to keep me calm, but now it has faded away. A tree. When I was little, I used to think they had eyes. I could always see them staring at me. Every time I felt lonely, I went to sit on the exact same tree and talk to it out loud. Here it is, my last goodbye to my greatest friend. I feel like I owe him an apology, but I just can't. I guess I just got tired.
Kinda typical, don't you think? The messed up one, ending her life the same way she has been living it. Drugs, alcohol, sex, and wasteful activities meaning so little in the moment, but so much in the end. Someone very wise once said, I was more addicted to the self-destruction than to the drugs themselves. Something very romantic about it. I will call my suicide a very romantic act of love and self-destruction. Not only for the fact that I'm killing myself, with the things that I like the most, but for an act of love. Not necessarily of being in love, but feeling love for someone.
As humans, we ruin everything we touch, including each other. I feel like this loneliness is starting to eat me again. All I can think about is the sadness in my head. No other emotions, they are all dead. I don't mean to be sad like this all the time. I don't want to bring others down or be a weight on anyone's shoulders. But I am, and I can't help it. Living is too difficult. To be honest, I just want to die. The walls are closing in. I'm being caved inside my own head, and my heart starts pounding like a thousand drums all at once. I'm tired of fighting. I'm ready to fall. Who knows? Maybe I'll fly.
Smoking cigarettes from a pack I was saving for a special occasion, inhaling smoke through my nose, feeling it in my lungs. I walked towards the kitchen without knowing the purpose of life, without knowing my purpose in time and space, feeling confused about the actions I was about to take, whether to live, risk it one more time, and walk away with a knot in my throat, full of regret, contempt. With bleeding inside the head, there is a metallic taste at the back of my throat. I do believe we are all mortal until the first kiss and the second glass of wine. But right now, this moment, I feel free. And indeed, I am free. I start falling asleep on top of the cold kitchen floor. I've always liked the color. I like it when I'm still. It is as though I was absent. The scent and the heat start spreading. There is dust on the ground, and I'm dying in such a special way many people can't afford. I shall sleep, but I shall not wake up.